15 years ago, the consumer would go to a local bank branch and they'd want a bundled set of financial products. That local bank branch manager would give them their credit card, their personal loan, their student loan, their mortgage. What you're seeing today is that new financial technology companies are using differentiated products to acquire scale really efficiently and much faster than they've ever seen before. The first is going from offline to online. Today, with complete mobile ubiquity and connectivity, you're seeing more consumers want to take a digital channel for all of their needs, especially their financial needs. The second is the consumer's trust for digital-first platforms. So more than half of the US population is now willing to go to a technology company for any of their financial needs. And the third is this approach around personalization and tailored product experiences. We've seen this massive trend in China, in India, in Latin America. In China, it's probably the best example. Most consumers in China go to technology companies for all their financial needs. You've seen Alipay and TenPay and some of these mobile payment platforms send all sorts of financial products at a faster pace than we're seeing in any other region throughout the world. So you're seeing these new platforms and other emerging fintech players scale rapidly and are now starting to compete with some of the biggest traditional banks in the world. And therefore, if you think about deal activity going forward, you could see some of the traditional financial institutions going after some of the technology platforms to add to their product capabilities and add to the overall experiences that they're delivering to their customers today.